Guess what? It's episode 20 already of Vinyl Happy Hour. It's been a really long day. We've had a lot going on. We were getting things ready for the Rockford Record Crawl coming up too. And I know it's pretty late, but we were like, we've got to do our weekly Vinyl Happy Hour. We don't stop putting out new records every week at Culture Shock. New releases don't stop coming in. So we're coming at you very late. So at the end of a long day, it's nice to have a little drink. Come home and listen to some records. We already got a chance to listen to the new Alkaline Trio a little bit ago. Really digging it. And I wanted to bust into a drink that I just had a little hankering for. Some Clyde Mays Straight Bourbon Whiskey. So I'll get started with our Vinyl Happy Hour. Hopefully you're tuning in and checking this out every week. Please let us know that you are and let us know what you think of the show. Any comments, please drop along the line. Lauren's back here too, manning the cameras for us. And so episode 20. Got a drink. I've got four different records to talk about tonight. Couple spanking brand new releases, and then I picked one. I'll just tell you, it came out of our Halloween bin and horror movie bin at Culture Shock, but it's a really cool one. So we're gonna do that one last. It's got a special poster with it too, and some color vinyl to ensue. But first, Clyde Mays Straight Bourbon Whiskey. It says it's an Alabama, you know, company and stuff like that. So that's always confused me. But then I remember it's actually distilled in Kentucky, because to be a straight bourbon whiskey, it does have to be made in Kentucky. But a cool story of background on the company. They were around pre-Prohibition era. And the owner, he actually even got jailed during Prohibition era. As the story goes, I guess the day he got out, he went right back to got some copper stills and started making whiskey again. So they've continued that tradition, I guess, their style of making it. It's a really great smooth bourbon, too. I really like it. It's got just a little spice to it. Not a lot of flavor to the aromas, but it really kicks in when you drink it. Just a little spice on the tongue, wash over the mouth, swish it around, down it goes. It's a great one. I just like to drink it neat, just right out of the glass, no ice, just kind of room temp or a little cooler. Don't mix it with anything. It's great that way. So, yeah, cool story on those guys, too. It's small batch, you know, this isn't like single barrel or anything. But yeah, I'll definitely be looking forward to drinking some more of that. My first release, like I mentioned earlier, is a new release from an older band. We didn't know what was going on with Alkaline Trio. If you're not familiar with them, their singer Matt Skiba, the last few years, he's actually stepped out of the band for a little bit, and he's been singing for Blink-182. So they haven't had a new album in quite a few years, but it's happy to say they have a brand new one out. So what is the name of it? I forgot. Oh, Is This Thing Cursed? Of course, I also love that they did a gatefold album, really nice heavy jacket. But what I really love is they did the indie store exclusive vinyl, color vinyl. It's got the phone dial on the center too. Great sound too. It's still got their old sound, very nostalgic sounding. Maybe a little less emo, a little more punk, pop punk sound. But yeah, it sounds like it's going to be a really great album. I haven't actually gotten into the B-side yet even. I had so many other things to check out and play with here tonight. So really cool. They also did just recently reissue all their live stuff that they did at the Metro, and a couple of their older albums just came out on like split color vinyl. So I thought that was really cool. If you're a big fan of Alkaline Trio, let us know what you think about the album, okay? And if you have a favorite of one of their old albums, let us know too. There's that new one. So be sure to check that one out. That just comes out tomorrow. That's why we do our Vinyl Happy Hour every Thursday night. We get new releases in and restock the store every Friday, so it's a good time to kind of go through and see what's coming in. Have you heard about Greta Van Fleet yet? They have so much hype going for such a young band. They've only had a couple like EPs out. I think they're still in their teenage years. Definitely worth checking out. It seems like they have a huge buzz going. This is what everybody says about them. Led Zeppelin. Everyone says, oh my God, it sounds like Led Zeppelin. Sounds like Plant. And it's true, they really do have a real Zeppelin sound. There's a little more bluesy and some folk sense to them, though. Just a great rockin' album. It's so cool that the artwork turned out all trippy and kind of stonery looking. These kids are young. It's three brothers and then a friend of theirs on drums. So it's kind of almost like that Kings of Leon style, you know, where they're all brothers in the band mostly, writing together since they were very young. But I don't care that people say they sound like Zeppelin. It's just cool. There's so many other good new bands that have a nostalgic sound or have this blues rock sound. Obviously, I'm into lots of stoner metal, stoner rock. They all sound like a little bit like Zeppelin and Sabbath and other bands like that, too. But yeah, finally, they've had so much hype going, they finally have a full-length album out. It's incredible how they've really taken off and seem to be really getting a lot of talk about them. So hopefully this will open up some people to checking out some different bands too. So that's the new Greta Van Fleet. Really great artwork, great sounding album. It definitely rips pretty heavy too. Next one, just a beautiful packaging, beautiful job on the sound of this recording. This is the new Jason Isbell in the 400 unit. It's called, I think it's just called Ryman? Yeah, Live from the Ryman. So there's this huge, it's not that huge, I guess. I've never been, so I can't judge it. But live in Nashville at the Ryman, a really nice recording sound. They played a few nights in a row there a couple years ago or last year and really got their sound down for this album. It's just a beautiful sounding album. If you're not familiar with Jason Isbell, just a great modern kind of folky soul artist with a big country kick. He was in Drive-By Truckers for quite a few years. You probably know him from that. He's been working with this band for a long time. What's really cool about this album too, they did a limited batch on double LP on kind of clear green vinyl. But what's really cool about a lot of the artists like this, they usually just play solo or something like that, you know? All these folky and country kind of players. It's got that really cool die-cut cover too that gives it that kind of church window feeling. But he's been playing with this band for a long time, so they really just kick together. There's a couple songs that are really tuned down, really kind of folky. But then there's some that just really swing and really hit really well. They're from, you know, Alabama, and they're playing in Nashville a lot, so it's got that really cool kind of Muscle Shoals sound. If you're familiar with that, a lot of the cool kind of soul sound mixed with their country vibe. But really great new release from them. I think a lot of people are going to really dig that. It's a really cool shot from their live show there. Double LP. You don't need to see the other one. It's green also. So check that one out. That's out tomorrow. My next one, I'm sure you're familiar with this show and the music on the show. But Halloween coming up and everything else going on, I had to show off this Walking Dead soundtrack. This has music from the first 7 seasons of the series. Even if you haven't seen it, I'm sure you can't get away from hearing people talk about it or seeing things come up about it. But I think it's just so cool right now, like I say every week, the stuff that's coming out on vinyl just amazes me. I can't believe how many great bands and artists are coming out with stuff on vinyl, and now we even have shows and soundtracks and Netflix series. It really reminds me of the classic years of vinyl, you know, which would be probably the 60s and 70s, and you look back and you see soundtracks from Taxi Driver or Saturday Night Live or Saturday Night Fever or whatever, you know, whatever was big then. You can see in your parents' collection or maybe your own collection, for a while that stuff wasn't coming out on vinyl very much. So, you know, that 90s and 2000s stuff. But how cool that not just bands are putting things out, but now even these really cool soundtracks. So this is a double LP, but it gets better. It's a gatefold. And they have printed inner sleeves. So the packaging on this is really cool. There's Rick, right? Is that his name? From the show, The Cop. But it's on kind of zombie clear marble green vinyl. So it's super zombie-ish. Here's your other insert. Some more artwork from the show. And you get some inserts. You get more inserts with it. And cool poster. There you go. So that's your Walking Dead release. It's really fun right now to check out all of the zombie movie, horror movie, and Halloween soundtracks and other spooky music and metal and other things we have right now at the store. So it's one of our favorite times of the year, of course. So I hope you've enjoyed this. Again, this was episode 20. If you haven't been keeping up with these or seeing these live on Facebook and Instagram, please go back and check out our YouTube Vinyl Happy Hour. Let us know what you think about the show. Let us know what kind of soundtracks you have in your collection or which ones you're looking for still. And if we don't have them, hopefully we can get them in for you. But Halloween time is definitely a good time to get these horror movie soundtracks. I'm going to eat my really late dinner now and finish drinking some bourbon. So have a great night. Thanks so much.